Well, good morning. Appreciate everybody coming out. We do have some seats up here for people that would like to sit down. If y'all would kind of pull on up and gather around, we're going to get this ceremony started. How's that? Yeah, good, good. Just please take a seat for those that would like to, and just gather on around so you can be close. I would remind you that there are some cones in the middle of the street, and those cones are meant to protect you from the oncoming cars that are going to the animal shelter. So if you would stay this side of those cones, that would be helpful to stay safe. I do want to remind you, or at least recognize, we have a number of aldermen here this morning. We have the Vice Mayor Blanton here, and we have Alderman Burger, who you'll hear from. You have Alderman Brown and Alderman Peterson. Did I miss anybody? And I'd always like to ask, if you are a veteran, please raise your hand. Lots of hands. We're here today to name our first street after a veteran, and this program was launched in 2018 to pick a neighborhood street and name it after a fallen veteran who died in combat. This program offers a street with a street sign and a new residential subdivision dedicated in a veteran's name. Alderman Beverly Burger introduced this program to the Board of Mayor and Aldermen and is here today to speak about that particular program. Alderman Burger.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Wow, who ordered this weather? It's great.
I did.
You did. Touche. City of, as we know, is naming its first street for a veteran street naming project for the Franklin veteran, Second Lieutenant Roy F. Alley, a World War II veteran and the recipient of a Purple Heart. He was born and raised in Franklin. He attended David Lipscomb College, and he graduated from Vanderbilt University, then served in the Armed Forces, where he was a bombardier and a crew member of the bomb aircraft responsible for targeting aerial bombs. And he was assigned to a group in the Philippine Islands and flew pre-invasion missions over Japan, the occupied islands in the South Pacific. Lieutenant Alley died in 1945 when his plane was shot down. The VF Post, I don't know if many of you know, here VF Post 4893 in Franklin is named after Lieutenant Alley. We have some of his family members who we'll be hearing from. Roy was their father and uncle. The street naming project idea was launched in 2018 to name new neighborhood streets after fallen Franklin veterans who had died in combat. The program offers builders and developers an opportunity to name a street along with a street sign for the new residential subdivision or a street in that area. And the program was introduced to the city by our local resident and citizen, retired U.S. Navy Captain Steve Arends. Steve, would you come up here with me for a minute, please? Thank you. Appreciate you being here today. Captain Arends moved here a number of years ago from Chula Vista, California, where they had instituted a similar program. And as a city alderman, Captain Arends contacted me, and together we brought this to the attention of our city. I can't thank you enough, Steve, for bringing this program to us. And I just want to say that we have numerous people here today who are veterans. I want to thank you for being here. I want to thank you for your service to our country. And the city of Franklin is very proud to bring this program here. And we will be hearing now from some of the relatives. Mr. Mayor, if you'd like to introduce them.
Well, thank you for bringing that to us, Bev. And today we have Ann Little and Roy Allen Jr. With us. And is there any other family, Ann? Oh, if you're part of the family, would you raise your hand so everybody can, wow. Great legacy, please.
Wow, it is wow to see this many of us. We get together usually once in the summertime, but we've not been together in, 2.5 to 3 years. But we have been looking for this for a long time. I want to thank the mayor and the alderman, and especially Bev Burger, who has had the people contact, and she has pushed this, and we're really proud of that. We're very honored to bless our uncle and a father and grandfather. There's one here that it's their grandfather. So we will remember this a long time because it's the beginning for our family, but there'll also be other families. And I hope we can also, maybe some of our family, when there is another one, that we can know about that and participate. Sometimes you wonder why you're doing something. And I decided to do a little cleaning up, which I needed to do more cleaning up than I did. But I found a box, and I thought, that looks familiar, but I don't know what's in it. So I opened it, and this was here. And I didn't know that they had one. But I also have this one. So I'm going to give those to my cousin today. I have one story about Uncle Roy. None of us ever knew him. And when you said he was born in 1945, I died in 1945 on the 23rd of April, and he was killed on the 20th of April. And I've often wondered, in when we were talking about this, how my parents worked through that time. It was a joy. I hope it was a joy that I was born. But to know that, and it could have been months before they knew he was had been killed, because with that time it was hard to know when it was. But anyway, we're glad to be here today, and I would like my cousin to join me up here. I'm just going
to. Oh, okay, that's fine. Good morning. I appreciate everybody being here. I'm proud to be a Roy Alley. There's a third Roy Alley in Greensboro. I never dreamed I would do that. There's a third Roy Alley in Greensboro, North Carolina, who's equally proud. And I think I can speak for the extended Alley family of cousins that a lot of you have seen, that all these cousins with many other names other than Allie, but we're all appreciative of this recognition today. However, we must remember that as important as Roy Allie was to us personally, he was one of many similar stories of the greatest generation. And although there are not many of them left today, we should never forget their well-earned description of the greatest generation. Not all will be honored with street names and VFW Post, and we are so very grateful for that recognition, and we hope the City of Franklin will continue that. Thank you all for being here, and we are very appreciative.
Thank you. Thank you, and God bless. Well, I think it's time to unveil the sign, and I think that I would invite all the family and relatives to stay up here to unveil the sign, please. I think it might be appropriate as we gather up here with the family that we just take a moment of silence to think about our fallen veterans, and also think about the world situation now that we're in, and the service of our current military. So join me with just a moment of silence. And amen. So I would invite Ann and Roy Jr. Where's your son? How about a countdown? That'd be fun, wouldn't it, on Monday? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pull it! Oh, great, great. Thank you. Alderman Burger, please.
Just want to let you know that we're always looking for either students, Boy Scouts, citizens who will help us research the people who served our country and died in combat or died in service to their country. And if you would like to participate or you know of other groups, Boy Scouts, students, senior citizens, just citizens of our city, please let Captain Arends and myself know. We would love to put you to work because this is a great program, and then we want to make sure that we are researching the people and can honor them as we have here today with Lieutenant Alley. And thank you again.
Thank you. Please come up and greet the family, and I think we're adjourned. Thanks for coming. Thank you.